Last time in EU4, we won two wars, which gave us Parma and Genoa. Then, one of the masterclass, we got a province over here owned by Genoa, Matrega. So we are near to Russia. We want to ally, but they don't want us. Just like real life. So yeah, that's what's basically happened last time. We kicked out Milan and the other little Italy states here. And we need some new allies. And okay, we could ally with Poland. Let's see. But yeah. So you can tell nobody really likes us, France. No way, Spain, no way. England. It's on the one side Moscovy or Poland. Which one is stronger? Let's see, let's see, let's see. Moscovy is clearly stronger. Poland than Lithuania. Hmm. I will go with Moscow, basically because their rivals, or normally their rivals are the Ottomans later in the game, so if we kick out Crimea here, which unfortunately is Sunni religion, but we can make them Catholic. So now it's our second war versus Milan, this time alone, and they're allied with Montfort and Ravensburg. But we are in a quite a good position because our army is very strong. I killed some rebels before and kicked out Lucca here, and they were just rushing everything. So our army is really good, and I don't think they have a chance, even if they are more. And they also got a bit of a rebellion. Oh no, what did I do? Around here, so... Ah! Hello there! You see me beating the shit out of Crimea, huh? Look at that! They're already gone before the war even started. Now, I hope I can give me and my ally some fucking territory. So after all these years, I've done it. I've come to the very end of the quantity ideas. That means I have a land force modifier of 50%. Now I can extend my force. My income is still very good. And also my army maintenance isn't that high for a big army. If you go now to the army size, you can see that I'm quite quite good in the mixing. I will also extinct my army, and that means we could catch up the Ottomans, and maybe we could also go to war with them. And you see, Austria would join in Russia. Okay, so fun fact, just the Holy War broke out, the War of Protestant League. So which side I am? Oh good, I'm the one with 320k infantry. So by the looks of that, we should be able to smash them. I'm going immediately at France, try to kick them out. So it's looking pretty shit right now. This fucking pig Francis have so strong armies, I don't know from where this is coming. Now the Ottomans are okay, it's fine, but still, this army is so fucking strong, look at that. The next thing, the stupid religion center, I'm just transforming my country into a literal shithole. And the next catastrophe is coming, a disaster, or whatever you want to say it. Just because they make all my religion so fucking weird. So the religious war finally is over. You see, it's cost a lot of manpower. Some of my ships sunk. Don't know what happened there. What was in the treaty. The Netherlands formed, but just had nothing to do with the war, and I don't know. But so from the territory size, nothing much happened. Protestant is not a religion in the Holy Roman Empire. It is time for the first war versus the Ottomans. I've decided to pick them basically because Russia and Austria are joining, and I think that's pretty fucking awesome. So let's see what we can do here. And I forgot Hungary. Even Hungary is on our side. So as you can tell, the war is going pretty good for us. Not here in the east, but because they're all the troops and they fight from them, but we go through the, I mean, the East Europe side, I don't know, attacking them and try to siege them out. If we have that done, I think we go over that, fight there a bit, so we can get more land and, yeah, get a better peace deal. That's it. See there. Now Constantinople has fallen. Very good, very good. Hey. So I might have made the Middle East a pretty damn fucked place. Now the Mamelukes tried to conquer all of this stuff and... I mean, Akkunyulu, or however they are pronounced, they're pretty good the whole game, and then I just run over them. I also took these provinces here, so I can take the Mamelukes later better without tripping. Then we can go this route down here. We can also try to attack Karaman, which is already allied with the Mamelukes, or Venice. And I think that's a pretty good idea. Ooh, nearly died there. Then we can get a new church power. The question is, what will it be? Manpower recovery speed. That wouldn't be bad. Product efficiency, but I already have enough money, so don't go with that. That's the question of missionary strength. I think I go with manpower. 600 per month isn't bad at all, especially for how much we need. So, oh look, they give us a gift. Austria is a very good ally. No wonder I loved him so much. So you can get, So what I want to look now is what's the trading routes like. I often don't look at this. So in Genoa, oh, pretty damn good, even though I thought France would be a bit better, but okay, I got very good province here, so makes sense. Venice, yeah, Ragusa, now I took this province, only third, but I think this will change if I conquer more of the Ottomans. Okay, Constantinople as always. Oh, look, a Crimea, the best again. So, and here I'm the fifth. Ooh. Hot. Oh, and Tunis the first. Oh, not bad at all.